We know that any prescription written for opioids could serve as a gateway to addiction.
Doctors, nurses, and pharmacists from hospital emergency departments across the state came together for a training on how to reduce opioid prescribing. It's part of a new state initiative called Opioid Reduction Options Program, or ORO, funded by the New Jersey Department of Health and New Jersey Department of Human Services. The state is providing $1 million for this program. In this cohort, there are 11 hospitals participating in the year-long program, and they'll get technical assistance and more training like the one here today.
I think a lot of physicians and clinicians are thinking about it. They're just not sure what's out there or how to do it. So what we're doing is we're trying to take that information, disseminate it down into quick and easy protocols that have been vetted, that are research-based.
Pain management and addiction medicine chief Alexis LaPietra and her team at St. Joseph's Health have been national pioneers in reducing opioid prescribing with their program ALTO, the Alternatives to Opioids program, which launched in 2016. It uses a combination of medications to treat pain. Opioids are only used as a second option.
So if we give one tablet of oxycodone, it masks pain. But if we give anti-inflammatories with acetaminophen, with small injections, with stretching, with patches, we get a little bit of pain relief with each one, and then combining them together, we get a really targeted actual treatment of the cause of pain.
We were able to get an 82% reduction in our opioid use.
St. Joe's serves as our gold technical partner.
In October of last year, President Trump signed a bill into law that appropriated money for grant funding so hospitals across the country could train nurses and physicians to build programs like ALTO.
We know that these programs do have a cost to them, but we know that the benefit is robust. So we'd like, President Trump wanted to at least provide that funding as the grassroots effort to get participants and departments on board where they would otherwise be motivated but have the lack of funding to really implement the strategies. And we're not sure when the appropriations will come out. We're not sure what the funding will be. So the state decided, no, we're going to do this right here and we're going to do it ourselves and own it.
New Jersey's made some progress in reducing opioid prescribing. From 2012 to 2018, we have actually seen approximately a 21% decrease and opioid prescribing among providers.
At the same time, part of the ALTO program aims to get addicted people into recovery.
What matters is who you hand off to in the community and their capacity and their ability to be able to follow up on the things that you have initiated.
The state agencies hope ORO will reduce overall opioid prescribing in hospital emergency departments to 12%. The national average is 17. In Princeton, Leah Mishkin, NJTV News.